Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about that is common ion effect, and in that case we have got to know that is it also have an effect on the solubility. So how can it affect the solubility of a particular electrolyte or of a particular particular substance, whether it would be in weak acid or weak base. So let us talk about it with the help of this example. So now we are going to discuss about what is the effect of the common ion, that is the common ion effect on the solubility, that is what we are going to talk about. So let me take an example like AgCl. So AgCl is basically a substance which won't dissociate completely whenever a saturated solution is being if we have obtained a saturated solution of that. So therefore it will give us basically Ag plus along with that of that is Cl minus, as you could see, but it won't dissociate completely. So that's the reason that it is not been all the moles of the AgCl are not being converted into their respective complete dissociation. On complete dissociation, they don't give us the pure concentration that was of AgCl. So that's the reason that a small amount of the AgCl will be dissociated, and that's the reason that we could get only a fraction of Ag plus along with that of the Cl minus. But this electrolyte or this kind of substance, they are dissociating till a particular extent, but still what we can do is we can make the substance in such a way that it won't dissociate it Ag plus along with that of the Cl minus ion. So that is basically known as a depression of the solubility. So that is what we are going to talk about. And since AgCl is as we know, that is, it is a sparingly soluble salt, so therefore it is the one that has been following an equilibrium, and the equilibrium is basically in this case could be called as a solubility equilibrium. And so suppose if that solution or that saturated solution consists of the AgCl along with that of the Ag plus and Cl minus, and in that solution suppose if we have added that is AgNO3, so AgNO3 is basically a soluble salt, and it dissociates completely into that is Ag plus and NO3 minus. But before making that, to understand that one, but we could also study about the solubility product, because in this case we are talking about the solubility. So therefore, according to this reaction that we have, so we can make the solubility product to be known as that is KSP for the AgCl, and that could be written as basically Ag plus concentration of Ag plus multiplied by concentration of Cl minus. So this is what we have. And let me tell you that the KSP value, it will be constant throughout, but the condition is it should be at constant temperature, and the temperature should not be changed. And that's the reason, because as you know that if temperature will increase, obviously the one which is not been dissociating completely, it will be dissociated to more extent. So that's the reason that we keep the temperature constant, and that's why we could obtain the KSP value, and that is nothing but the product of the concentration of the ions, that is cation and anion. So this is what we have got. So again, coming back to the same thing that we have talked about earlier, that is whenever the AgCl has been present in a solution, and what we have to do is we have to suppress or we have to decrease the solubility of that particular substance, that is AgCl. So what we have to do is we have to add a particular substance which consists of the same ion. So for an example, if I add AgNO3, so as I talked about earlier also, that is AgNO3 is the substance which is basically the soluble salt. And so that's what it will dissociate completely into, that is Ag plus along with that of NO3 minus. But the solution also consists of that is AgCl along with that of we could say like Ag plus along with that of that is Cl minus. So in this case, if you observe that the concentration of the ions that has been in more amount, that is Ag plus, and this is the equilibrium that has been we are maintaining. So this is the solubility equilibrium that has been maintained. So as to establish this solubility equilibrium, we know that AgCl will convert into Ag plus along with that of Cl minus. So that is what we know. But by adding AgNO3, we could see that the Ag plus concentration is going on increasing. So now the equilibrium is not been maintained, because the concentration that has been present on the right side, or we could say in that manner, is more of the Ag plus, and that of the AgCl is comparatively low, because we are talking about equilibrium. So what happens is, because of the concentration is more on the right hand side, according to the Lee Chandler's principle. So that's the reason. So as to remove that stress, or so as to reduce that stress, obviously the equilibrium will shift from right side to left side. That is from right side to left side. So in that case, we could say that as the AGCL will now be combined with that of the CL minus, so as to produce that is AGCL. So that's the reason that we are making the solution to have less solubility. So in this case, because as we know that is AgCl was separating into that is Ag plus and Cl minus, but because of the common ion that we have added over here, so we could say that again the process can be go in a reverse manner, or we could say that the equilibrium will shift from right to left side, and that's how we could obtain that is the decrease in the solubility of AgCl. So this is the effect that was being raised because of the Lee Chandler's principle that we have got to know, and mainly the common ion that is present in the solution. And this is what I was talking about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know that is how can we decrease the solubility of a particular substance by adding the same ion, which is known as common ion effect. And that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you share this video with the friends, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much.